Now we have a participant from an institution called Indic Academy, Kavitha Krishna, who normally resides in US, but she has taken the pains to come to India. Can I request her to say a couple of words?
Pranams to Acharyas, and thank you so much, Ananji. I cannot match what they all spoke, Sanskrit, Bengali, so mine is going to be very dull, so I'll keep it very short. So I wanted to thank all of you and also Indic Academy mainly. So Sri Charan and I have come through Indic Academy, indictoday.com if you all want to check. They have conducted essay contests and they selected us and they sponsored this whole workshop for us. July 21st to 28th, there is another workshop that they're sponsoring, so you're all welcome. All Sanskritists, please write for it. It is on leadership role models from Mahabharata or something like that. You can check that. And if you're selected, it's all paid workshop in Nilgiris. So something like this again, but not by sir and ma'am. I will write it down. So I live in the US and I teach American diplomats coming to India, Indian language and culture. So this has been very, very useful to me, ma'am and sir, because I encounter a lot of negative impressions about India, Hindu, Indian culture. Recently, you probably read the news, you know, India has the crime capital against women, and it's all like prachar because it's perception, it's not reality actually. The whole statistics is all wrong. Now, if I have this kind of knowledge, like you have given in the past few days, unfortunately, I came in the middle, and there's a story to that. So all this is very useful to me because I go back and I can counter, I can refute. I have like, you know, I'm from the primary sources, now I know how what to quote and what to say, so it's very useful to me. Secondly, I also feel that for future generations, like you were mentioning, it's very important that the youth, and it's, I was so happy to see so many youngsters knowing this. Like I am from Arsha Vidya Gurukulam and I study Vedanta with Pooja Swamiji and his teachers. All of us are very older people, senior, and to see youngsters knowing all this, knowing Upanishads, Gita, just quoting and being very proud of who you are, it's beautiful to see. Because in, especially in the South, Andhra, Telangana, I can talk about is people are just into engineering and other areas. There's no humanities. India needs humanities. India needs the youth in humanities to understand our primary sources, study it, learn it, write about it, like he was asking. And also like Sri Charan was talking about, he's a physics student and he writes about yoga and physics. It's an amazing essay. You should read that. So you can bring forth something new like our ancient seers did. So we can't constantly study what they did, but we also have to come up with something new for the future and contribute. So in that sense, when I see you all doing humanities, it's fabulous because it's probably not easy. A lot of pressure must be there. Are MCA karlo, MBA karlo, or something like that. You know, so I face that also because when I went for Vedanta, they're like, "What are you crazy? You're living in the US. Why are you here?" So it is very complicated to live in this today's world with competition and do all what you're doing. So thank you and an amazing job and please keep it up. Course-wise, I loved that this has helped me and I can use it in my work. And as ma'am was saying, it's a very, very practical text. So there's a lot of primary texts that we can study and it's great. You feel very happy intellectually and also spiritually maybe. But to implement it in a very systematic manner, this is a great test to do that. So next time we meet, maybe in a year, I suppose all of us will be Amoghava, something like that. Are barish nahi ho rahi hai, barish ruk jao, something like that, you know. So, but use it for with dharma, not adharma. So maybe we can all do that. So that'll be very quickly, this place is great for Swadhyaya. I'm going to stay back. So all that I've studied and I missed 3 days because I landed from the US in Delhi. I got to know that I was selected very last minute. And my plan was to take my mother to Angkor Wat, Cambodia, to see the Hindu temples there, which we did. And I write about it usually. I do all this. So I took her, came back to Delhi. They said, "You're selected. Can you make it for the camp?" I said, "Ek din late jaungi." Then 22nd, and we were contacting with Ananji, who was like so amazing with all the logistics. And then my flight got cancelled, so ultimately I landed up very late. Hopefully the Gadwali gang will teach me tonight whatever I missed. I'm hoping. So it has been a long journey. I have not gone home. That was the point I was trying to make. I landed from the US and I have not gone home. And my parents are like, "Kya pagalo?" Because already I'm going on July 21st to Coimbatore for another Vedanta camp. So they're like, "Ghar mein kab rahogi?" But I think knowledge is bigger than individual family, and it is so important. What India has to offer is bigger than anything like personal parents, and you know, if you have mumukshutvam, then everything surpasses that. So that's all I wanted to say, and namaskar, thank you. I will write that down.
Thank you, Kavitha ji. I hope Indic Academy will be in touch with the Rishi Rina Trust, so there could be some synergy in the whole process. So in view of the paucity of time,